Hello everybody, I'm Sneetsy Gamer and welcome back to Dark Souls 3. I finished the game in my last episode, but in this one I'm probably going to be doing mostly PvP stuff, see how well I can do, but I'm going to be using my other character. This is the one I was playing for the videos. I'm going to be using this character though, because I am much better with this character than I am with the one I was doing the videos with. So yeah, I want to do some PvP stuff. I might have to change my, I don't remember leaving it right there. I may have to change my covenant here just to get some... just to go ahead and do some PvP stuff. Well, first I'll go and find an area that I want to go to. I could do undead matches, but those are... yeah, I might do an undead match. So, for the duel there's... one-on-one, fight till one has fallen. Use of Estus Flask is forbidden. Use of Ashen Estus Flask is limited. Then we've got two-player brawl, every man for himself. Compete for the most kills within the time limit. Use of Estus Flask and Ashen Estus Flask is limited. Four-player brawl, same thing as the last one. Six-player, same thing. Brawl group, join either four-player brawl or six-player brawl. 2v2, we've got combatants are divided into two teams. Compete for the most kills within the time limit. Use of Estus and is limited. 3v3, co-op match, join either 2v2 or 3v3. And then back to duel again. I've done one duel before. Kiln of Flame, Grand Roof, Dragon Ruins, Round Plaza, or random. I'm just gonna go and travel somewhere and I'm gonna try to invade or something. So yeah, in this playthrough, this is my third time through the game. I'm already up there. I'm gonna go here because I do want to get to another bonfire here, and then I might just use the Aldrich Faithful Covenant here so I can invade when people come through. Yeah, I made somebody pretty happy the other day. I was trying to remove the Dark Sigil on this character, and because the cost to remove it scales with your character level and your number of Dark Sigils. So I had the maximum 5 Dark Sigils, and I was... well, my character's over level 200. It cost me nearly 2 million souls to do it. So what I did was, before I went and did that, when I had the like 2 million souls, what I did is I just made sure I was embered, and I came out here, went over here, and waited for somebody to invade me. Because when you invade somebody, if you kill them, you gain, I don't know if it's all of the souls you get that they had, or if you gain like half or something, but you gain souls equivalent to at least part of what they had. So if they gained half of what I had, that person just gained over 1 million souls. So I made somebody's day. But... yeah, I decided to do that. I was gonna do some more, but I figured, you know what? After trying to invade in a few areas, I was gonna try to invade as a dark spirit and let somebody defeat me, because I know they gain souls from that as well. Let's see. I'm going to... See, the weapon I'm using here is the one that I wanted to get. The one that I wished I had gotten. One of the ones I wished I had gotten with my other character. It's the Hollow Slayer Greatsword. Why did I do that? Greatsword used for a lifetime by a masked knight harbors the fears that lurk within the minds of Hollows and is particularly effective against them. So it does more damage to Hollows. Then another one, the one that I wished I had to fight Medir with my other character was this one, the Wolf Knight's Greatsword. Because this one swings much faster than that one. The Wolf Knight Greatsword swings much faster. The damage would have been about equivalent, because with this, with my stats, I've got 541. But another weapon that I've got on this character that I absolutely love is Twin Prince's Greatsword. I got that on my New Game Plus, because apparently what you need to do for that, you get... You get the... one of my messages was raided. You get the... That's cool. When your message gets raided, it heals you. If you've got a message that gets raided, you actually get healed when they raid it. But the Twin Prince's Greatsword, which is quite powerful, actually, with an attack rating of 613 right now with my stats. What you had to do was you had to, with the Soul of the Twin Princes, Lothric and Lorien, you had to get both of the weapons that you can get from that, from those, that soul. And then you had the option when you spoke to the guy, what's his face, Bloodwith, is that his name? You had the option to combine them. And I was like, huh, that's new, what's that do? And when I did it, I got the Twin Prince's Greatsword, which is pretty damn powerful, actually. I've been using that. Plus, I like the weapon art for this one. If you use Light Attack, you get that, which is the blast that, Lothric used, or you get this heavy attack, which is fire. So you get both magic and fire from it. I'm pretty sure the first one used magic. I haven't actually checked that, but I can almost guarantee it's magic damage. But I want to go down here and I want to get this this bonfire opened up, and then I might just... And I might just stay here and do the invasions as a, Aldrich Faithful. But yeah, I haven't cleared these things out of here yet. Oh yeah, another thing that I really fucking love with this character. Chaos Bed Vestiges. It is extremely powerful. Yeah, I've got fucking 43 embers. I'm gonna use this sword, I think. Because I believe these things were vulnerable to fire damage. Maybe not. That does nothing. Oh, there it did some good damage. Oh, So yeah, this is how in the end of the last one, it asked me if, or not the end, but after I defeated the Soul of Cinder and I did the ending thing and all that, it asked if I wanted to start Journey 2. I'm on Journey 3 with this character. Oh yeah, these are definitely vulnerable to fire. What the? Are you kidding me? And it killed me. Fuck. How did it catch me? How did it grab me that quickly? So yeah, I do still get killed pretty often, actually. But that's to be expected. I might just run through and ignore the deacons up above for now. I can come out and kill them while I'm waiting to invade someone. In the meantime, you know what I could do? I've never done this one before, but in the meantime, I could be a Blade of the Dark Moon or a Blue Sentinel. But I prefer Blade of the Dark Moon, and then I'll invade to help people out when they get invaded by a dark spirit. Or I won't invade, I will be summoned to help them out. Too far out, and I'll risk getting hit by their fireballs a lot more. Gotta be careful. I want to get my souls before I try to fight this thing because I don't want it to kill me again and lose those souls. Because after I kill this thing, that's probably going to be enough for another level. There we go, it is staggered. A critical eye. And finish him off. There we go, then the bonfire appears. So we can light the bonfire. Go ahead and come over here and offer all of the human dregs that I've got to this. Then, because I've got enough to level up, I'm gonna head back to the shrine and do that. But yeah, making that nearly 2 million, it was like 1,895,000 some souls I needed to heal the Dark Sigil.
Welcome home,
Getting to
Spirit.
that was quite
Very
the
well, then taken.
quite the feat. Yeah, it cost me 374,000 souls to level up right now.
Farewell, Ashen One.
Aldrich Faithful. I don't know if I have to be in the area for it to summon me, but... No, why'd I go there? Now I have to climb up that long-ass ladder. I should have gone to the other part. But because I'm going to be invading others, I want this sword because it seems to do pretty good damage against most other players. Because chances are most other players are probably going to be hollowed at some level. Maybe not fully, like, the full 99 hollowing, but it does additional damage to hollows, and I believe that includes players who are hollow as well. And I don't know if I can invade here because I've killed Aldrich. I don't know if that stops me from being able to invade here. I know it prevents you from being invaded by Aldrich Faithfuls once you've killed him, but I don't know if it prevents you from invading if you've killed him. Oh, nope. Invading another world. Let's do this. And I'm probably gonna get killed. Chances are I'm not going to kill most of these people, but I want to try it. The knights are still alive up there, so they haven't gone that way yet. Chances are they haven't gone that way yet. Yeah, no, they're not in there yet. Where are they? Over there. Okay. Let's get over there. Spirits can injure me as well. How the hell did they get out there? Somebody's doing something weird. Really? God, I hate when people do shit like that. Now, what happened there is either they disconnected or they did something, I don't know. But they didn't stay in fight. They left somehow, and yeah, that just... That just wasn't cool. He was hiding out there, not actually fighting. At least actually fight if you're gonna be in this area. Or if you don't wanna fight, at least... Oh, same guy. I guess he's gonna do it again. Now, of course, he's down there again. Guess he's gonna disconnect again. How? What's going on here? He's gonna either leave or whatever, and I'm not gonna be able to be here again. Or not. This guy is so fucking annoying. Okay, fine. You want to play like that? That's how you're gonna play it. This guy's getting annoying. What, did he sneak around me? Maybe he went the other way? I don't know. Where the fuck did the guy go? I see. Just fucking gank it and kill him off. Shit, hit the wrong button. God, this is so fucking annoying. Or not. Or I am. How the hell did he get a third hit? How the hell did he get a third hit in with that? Oh well. I seriously would like to know how he got a third hit with that. Because I've used that weapon. Pretty sure it doesn't get three strikes. Maybe it does. Maybe there's a button that you push to get a third hit. I don't know. God, I hate these things. Let's try something different. I can't do that one because I'm not there. I could go to this and then head over to Fair and Keep or the what the hell is it called? Crucifixion Woods, that's what it's called. I could head over there, but first I want to drop off these, the dregs that I picked up. I got at least one or two more. I haven't gotten 10 of them doing that, huh? Head over here. Because I get invaded over here all the time, so there's probably gonna be people to invade here. I'm almost always, every time I come through here, I'm getting invaded by Watchdogs of Faerun, so I'm almost positive I'll be able to get somebody here. Are you fucking kidding me? figure might as well kill some of the enemies out here while I wait to invade someone. Yeah, the only reason that guy was able to parry me is because I wasn't paying attention. I was just trying to hit him. I wasn't paying attention to what he was doing. If I had been watching what he was doing, I probably could have avoided that. But, oh well. I didn't really want to stick around there any longer anyways. That guy wasn't really... I mean, I understand you don't really get... Like, you don't fight fair in that area when you get, like... 3-4 people all coming in to invade you. I can understand being something like he was, but kind of sucks. Yeah, let's see if I can get anybody here. I'm hoping I'll find someone, but I don't know. My level might not be my soul level might be too far out of range here. And I'm using the Morn's armor because it's one of the better armor sets as far as I can tell. Let's get back to my... I've got every single weapon I've picked up on me right now. Just because I'm like that. I went to this because I think this is more effective on those. Those. Whatever they are over there. I forget what they're called. These things here. I believe this was more effective. Yeah, killed them in 4 hits. The other one took 5 hits. I know the fire stuns them a bit, but... But this does more damage and kills them off faster. Am I really not going to be able to invade anybody here? Huh. Got ourselves this Black Knight over here. Let's go ahead and see if I can take him down. Because he does a ton of damage. See? It doesn't look like I'm gonna invade anyone here. What else could I do then? You know, I've gotten to the Cleansing Chapel. I could go into the Painted World and invade there. I'm sure I'd be able to invade somebody in there. See, I wanted to try to do some PvP in this episode, but so far it's not working out. Where else could I go? I don't have much opened up right now, so... I could always go up here and see if I can invade anybody. Because up here I won't, if that guy's down in that area, it won't invade up here. From up here, I won't be able to invade that guy who's down there. Let's go back to being an Aldrich Faithful for now. Plus, these knights give me a fair amount of souls. So in the meantime, while I'm waiting, I can actually fight something that's going to really give me some skills. I would think the Aldrich Faithful can invade in this area. Yep. Or not. Somebody must have been coming through here and gone into the boss fog. That is an issue I'd have to worry about, is people going into the boss fog if I invade here. Which I can't blame them. I've been on that side of things. You're just trying to get through the area and you keep getting invaded, so you just start running for the boss fog. Aborted due to timeout. That's not from them running into the boss fog, then. Plus, I suppose being here, the deacons. Oh. Try again, I guess. Or not. Being here, I can kill those other deacons still and gain human dregs from them as well. Not as many of them here, but I've still got a good chance of getting things from them. Yeah, I don't understand why it's timing out. It might be that I've got a poor connection. Either I've got a bad connection or the person I'm trying to invade does. One of the two, I'm assuming. I'm assuming that's what's causing it. These things are vulnerable to fire. So I can just do this. Got plenty of stuff to keep me busy while I wait for invading someone. If it works. Because it keeps trying to, but it doesn't seem to be working ever. Invading another world. There we are. There we are. It worked that time. I swear, it better not be that same person. Why? Okay, so it's not that same person, but still, why the hell did it invade down here if I was all the way up there? Does it not matter where you are? I always like to bow, just kind of as a courtesy thing, like good fight sort of thing. Even if I'm invading, I always like to bow. That must be the one that I had killed as it was as I invaded. Sounded familiar on that person. I think I've seen them around before. Like, I know obviously Salary, that's a word, is Salary, but I've seen that character name before. I think I've run into them somewhere before. So apparently I was wrong about not invading people down there. Well, just for a change of pace, let's do this. Might be a good idea to go somewhere else, otherwise I might go into that person's game. I might end up in their world again as a helpful person instead, and that might just be confusing to someone. So after I offer you this, I'm gonna go somewhere else. That has to have been at least 10 now. Yep, Great Deeps. Master of Sorceries I just got. That means that was the last sorcery I needed to find. Yeah, let's go ahead and... Well, let's go to Lothric Castle. I've been invaded a couple times around here. People might need a little help here. Time now, please. There we are. And while I'm here, because I get a pretty decent amount of souls out of these guys, not these ones, but the knights. Knights give a decent amount of souls. But yeah, my stats on this character are way better than the one I was using for the video, but it's to be expected when you're this much farther into the game. When I've spent like twice the hours on this character. Yeah, I've found that seems to work pretty well with many situations. These guys typically will block it though. That time he didn't, but he usually did. Could make my way through this area and just wait to be summoned, I guess. I don't know if you have to be within the same area for this one or not. I would assume you do. Assume you have to be within the same area or within a certain distance of that area. Be wary of fatty visions and dual wielding. I didn't need the twin axes because I've already got a pair, but that works. Now, I don't think I was able to aim this up there enough to get that guy. Yeah, no, I'm down here now with these guys around. I would have thought that I would have been summoned by now, but then again, people this far into the game probably aren't going to be using the, the Way of Blue Covenant. People this far into the game are probably going to be able to hold their own pretty well. I've got a ton of weapons with this character, but then again, third time coming through the game, I should have most weapons. Might as switch over. I still need this because there's more knights up here. Although the fire does help on these knights, I think. Yeah, I killed the one dragon thing. I haven't gotten around to that one yet. Fire definitely works well on these guys, but not that well. It does work on them, though. I might just try to push forwards here and hopefully I'll get summoned, but I don't know. Otherwise, I could throw my summon sign up above at the, what's it called? The Dragon Slayer armor. I got too far away, so he turned around. These guys still do a shitload of damage. They always do, though. God, there's two of those guys up there. Yeah, until I get rid of that other guy, this isn't gonna work. Now I can fight you. There we go. Yeah, I don't think I've even come in here yet. There's one way to know. Nope, I haven't been in here yet. But yeah, it looks like I'm not gonna get summoned to help anybody with invaders here. Like I said, this far into the game, people probably aren't going to be using that covenant. Just get that activated. I don't need to go down there. So, let's go with Warriors of Sunlight, and then I'll put my summon sign right here. And somebody might summon me to help them with that fight. Oh, this is a bad idea. Soul of a Champion, that's one of the highest level souls that you find. Gives you 25,000 souls. That is a mimic, I believe. Yep. Sunlight straight sword, right? Yes, I already have one of them. Braille Divine Tome of Lothric, Darkstone Plate Rune plus one. Okay, so far I'm not getting summoned for that fight either. Damn. I was really hoping I would be able to do something here. I wanted to do something helpful as well, not just PvP. Not just PvP and then PvE for my stuff. I wanted to actually be summoned as a helpful phantom, but that doesn't seem to be working so far. Although I am here earlier than you normally are, so that might be the issue too. No, if I do get summoned while doing this, I'd rather have the stronger weapon. I've got a lot of weapons here. Most of them I don't even use. No illusory wall ahead. There wasn't anything over on this end, was there? No. Knight's Arena. I'll be able to just sell that because I've already got one. Be wary of hole. Oh, there is. There's actually a little hole there. Now, this is definitely a tougher one of these knights. Because he's got the red eyes. The ones with the red eyes are always tougher than the normal ones. Thankfully, their weapons are pretty damn slow. Praise the sun. Let me get Titanite Scale there. So let's offer the Sunlight Medal or medals that I have. I've only got one. Ah, I got a new miracle as well. Now I should be. What? Aw. Anyways, I was gonna say I should be clear to go all the way down here and out to that other bonfire because I think I killed everything. But then again, it would have been quicker to just do that too. I was thinking so I wouldn't lose my summon sign, but I would have anyways, so it doesn't matter.
Welcome, husband. Very well, then take. Farewell.
So yeah, I got two new magic things that I can use. I've got Sunlight. Oh no, Sacred Oath. Boost attack damage absorption for self and vicinity. And then I also got Great Deep Soul. Yeah, I'll sell a bunch of shit off.
Ah, well.
Can't remember if I've picked up any of the ones that I would already have had. I don't believe I have, but I can still check. Nope. Now here I've got some stuff, I just gotta figure out where they went. I know I picked up something. Or I'm pretty sure, yeah, there. Yeah, see, I've got that weapon that guy used, and I don't remember ever getting 3 hits in with it, but I don't know, maybe I just didn't do it right, who knows. Maybe I haven't gotten a critical with that before I thought I had, but, or a repost, I mean. I thought I had, but maybe I haven't. Okay, looks like I did not pick up anything new. Don't need that. Yeah, I've got a lot of stuff here that I don't need, but I also like to keep some of everything. I don't don't keep the Lothric Knight armor ever, because that's easier than hell to find that stuff. And the Evangelist hat and stuff, I don't usually keep those either. Deacon robes, don't need those. Silver Knight gauntlets. I knew I had picked up some Silver Knight stuff. It was just the gauntlets though, right? Got another extra here somewhere then. Oh yeah, the other knight ring that I just picked up. There.
Ashen one. Oh.
Now, what else could I do in this episode? I suppose I could try a duel. Random arena, let's try it. Please wait. All combatants present, moving to arena. That went quick. First time I did that, it took a little while. To that. Looks like this guy's gonna get me. Unless I can take him out with those. Oh boy, that's a bad connection. Yeah, I don't know. Is that the Grave Warden twin blades that he was using? Looked like it. But I don't remember ever seeing that. How you would have done that, but it looked like this weapon, because I'm pretty sure I've seen the Grave Wardens do that. I don't know what other twin blades would have been able to do that. Because it wasn't like it was in a combo. That was the attack he was using right away. That's right, I was taking... Whoops. That's what he was using. That's cool, I like that. Leap forward and slash mercilessly with both blades, cutting open foes. That's what he was using. Okay. I knew it was some sort of twin blade. That would be a bit cheap to use in an undead match, I think. Spell buff 199 versus 136. Dang, that's quite a drop. If I reinforce that, I might be able to get more for it, but I don't, or get more from it, but I don't think I've got what I need to reinforce, and I don't think I can buy it.
Ashen one.
Because I think that takes Twinkling Titanite. Yeah, Twinkling Titanite.
Okay, be careful, I don't.
Do you have any?
Oh, and.
Got three of them.
Goodbye, Moth.
Because then I can cast both miracles and pyromancers from that.
Pretty, be careful.
I can cast either this or this. But you know what I want to try? Because I've heard that it works really well on enemies. I want to try this. Was there a catalyst that worked as pyromancy flame as well? I don't think there was. Or if there was, I don't believe I've got it. That's possibly... I don't have the eyes with one, do I? Oh yeah, there it is. It was long before the dawn of chaos and pyromancy. Yeah, I don't think we've got one that can do both. Weird. Because there's a thing that can be used for both the pyromancies and the miracles, and there's a chime that can be used for miracles and sorceries. But I'm not seeing anything that can be used for pyromancies and sorceries together. Weird. Oh well. Kind of want to try this on this boss just to see how it works. Because it's supposed to work pretty well against bosses, but this one might be a little too mobile for that to work. Boss might move a bit too much for this to work because they have to stay within the cloud of it. Shortcut ahead. Yeah, we've got the thing down here. It's a shortcut. Otherwise, it's just a death. Change things up a little bit. Like only using one sword instead of both, that will help. Use a lighter helmet. It's not a whole lot lighter, but it is lighter. Might work. What were the ones that I normally use? Dragon Slayer gauntlets, that's right. That looks fucking weird. But yeah, I kind of just want to try this out and see how it works on him. Drawback is it also damages you. If you stand in it, it damages you as well. So. Yeah, my new game plus, I discovered that pyromancy seemed to work pretty well on this guy. He's quite a difficult fight. That pestilent mist did not do what I wanted it to in there. trying to get to the point where I can use, where is it? This. I want to see how well that works. Looks like I'm gonna have to do more PvP if I want interaction with other people now. I could always go to here and then just put my sign down, because I've seen some people tend to do that. I suppose this would be a good idea, a good place for it if you... Wait, this is not the bonfire I wanted to go to. That's the one I wanted to go to, the High Wall of Lothric. I've seen summon signs around here before, so it's probably... People would probably like to go here because it doesn't... The enemies aren't going to be interfering much. Their people can summon me and they know what to expect when they see that one. The purple one, because it shows up purple, they know it's a mad dark spirit or something like that it's called. Go here and I'll just invade as well as that dark spirit in this area. Like, I don't even have to put my summon sign down, I can just invade. Shouldn't be too difficult to find one in this area. People are always fighting in this area. There's always PvP going on here. It's a very big place for PvP. I swear, if it's that same guy from earlier, I'm not gonna be impressed. Kill the host or one phantom. No, I better go over here just in case they're going up there. I'm gonna turn the thing. They probably went the other way. But because I saw their sword go in there as I came in, as I invaded, I saw their sword go through that doorway. Down there. Shoot. Oh well. Just wanted to make sure they weren't using that ring that makes them look like a phantom. Ooh. My opportunity for a critical hit there. Does that count?
Yep.
Duty fulfilled. I killed a phantom. The hell? So the Blade of the Dark Moon does work here. Apparently, I want to do that then. Because I do want to do the Blades of the Dark Moon stuff. I want to invade, or I want to be summoned to help somebody. I think he might have gotten too close to the edge and just fallen off because they don't normally come down there. Damn, I forgot how much damage they're doing to me now. I want to get summoned at least once. If I get summoned once, then I'll be good. I will be able to. I'll be able to continue on with my day. That's all I want, is to get summoned to somebody's world once to help them. Yeah. spear piece here. I hate those. Okay, apparently I'm not gonna get it. I'm not gonna get summoned here. If I don't get summoned by the time I've killed these other knights up here, then I guess I'll just get summoned, I guess. Because I do need to end this episode. I didn't plan on it being as long as the others were, but I was getting there, so. Just in case I get killed. I don't want to have to teleport up here. Well, not really teleport, but whatever the hell it is. Warping through the bonfires. They deal so damn much damage if they hit. Which they do have a tendency to do usually. Okay, it looks like I'm probably not gonna get summoned. Then I guess I'm gonna have to end this one here. I was hoping to do some more. Maybe I'll do another one later on once I've gotten into the Ringed City and stuff. I might be able to invade a bit better there, but that's it for this one. Thank you everybody for watching. I hope you enjoyed, and as always, I'll see you in the next one.